Airport, we've got a railway line, we have a monument. We've got another thing, infrastructure, because we've got factories.
So why is the...
There's no need for anybody to start building.
And exactly. So why is the provincial government not really focusing attention on how to kickstart the industries again here?
Let's go back to history. That's why I said Jesus came. If historically, a lot of forts have been fought here, historically, they made sure purposely that there is no investment here at this site. A lot of resistance was happening this site. You see, we were surprised to find out that even that thing of Montrose, where they were told to kill cattle, it happened this site. So the English made sure that this land, look at this, this area, is not, there's no investment. There's no development. It is not developed. But came this Jesus, who was saying Jesus, because he came and changed everything. He started developing.
Where is he? You don't have his picture.
He's dead.
You don't have his picture at all.
I'll try to find it for you, but we don't have his pictures. Okay. No, look, the problem is the politicians. They do not want him
to be immortalized.
Yeah.
Who is this? What's his name?
Lennox Sebe.
I'm sorry, Dr. Who?
Lennox Sebe. He was the one.
Dr. L. Sebe. Okay,
he was overseas, right?
I'm not sure whether he was. He went. He was educated overseas. So, I'm not sure whether he was. But one thing that I heard from the politicians, he liked to read these Pan-Africanist books. Yeah. Hence, he was able to do all these kinds of things. One of his messages that I know of, because I was a Boy Scout then, he said, no, work for these Chinese. In time, you'll be the one who take over these factories.
Yeah.
Because these Chinese were not paying anything. Hence, his motto was, a half a spoon is better than nothing. At this moment, just take what you can get. Acquire skills.